and things like that. So I know that you are probably busting to get started in Blender, but since this is part one, I want to take 60 seconds as quickly as you can to the point that even the developers are like, like it's unrecognizable from the default Blender. Well, if you go to File, New, it restores the default layer. So Blender, like you know, like Photoshop, it's a very big change, like a toolbar or a panel or something like that. So we just keep, like, say I went to the so that's just an example. Like, yeah, the stuff that you change that you do here in 3D, what you change. So that's the basics of that. Now, moving around in the 3D is done with your middle mouse button. So you click and hold that in, you are now orbiting. So we are now sort of rotating around 360 degrees of your scene. Now, this orbiting function, I remember when I first started, it was very, like, there were times when I was like, I did that, and I'm like, oh, what's going on? Everything is upside down. And it was like, so jarring. So the thing to remember is if you get to the middle mouse button could emulate the right mouse and then you can control the left hand. But honestly, you should get it. But anyways, click number pad, and then click save as the next thing on. Otherwise, okay. So, moving around, we're looking at the top view. Now, let's say we don't want to have to look at the cube right now. What our focus is on is that right there. So the way that you would have to look at that is by holding down the shift, and then your mouse button drag. And we're sort of moving. So we're moving around. Okay, so that's good practice, all right? Good practice. I won't be checking your homework, but if we could sort of just move from object to object. It's good practice. Now, there is actually an easy way to, like, don't think you have to do it for everything. So say I was on this cube and I wanted to look at that. So first of all, I would select the camera. Anywhere in the camera. You're not selecting it. You got this dumb little. But it's annoying. It's like this piece by piece. If you hit number pad, period. Now it brings that directly to the
focus.
Now I can select the lamp.
You're playing the guy, and then you play the
lamp. Now I select the cube. And now I'm looking at the cube. Okay? So those are some very basic things. So we discussed in this part one, which was very dry and very boring. Orbiting, middle mouse click. Panning with shift, middle mouse click. Top view, 7, front view. One side view, just three, or one extra register. You push number pad 5, it takes it from perspective mode. The majority of what you're using is under that mesh. So these are other software sometimes called
and
primitives.
Don't forget to click on bell icon.
It's just a basic object. So sphere, you click sphere, brings in a sphere. You can delete, you can just hit delete. I'm not sure if I addressed that before. But anyways, so you can bring in any of these objects here. Another shortcut for delete is X, by the way. Just hit X. So you can bring a panel here. You've got options, like you could make it like high resolution smoke. So that now it's like you get more plume smoke, which is kind of cool. You could make it higher resolution, so it's like a nicer looking smoke. And also, if you select the Susanna head and then change the smoke type to fire and smoke, hey, now it's a crazy flaming head like out of that nickel. A lot of them. Now, if you're struggling to remember it, don't worry about writing notes, because there is a free keyboard shortcut PDF on my website. So if you click here right now, just go to the website and then type in your email address and send that to your inbox. So it's a handy little guide. It's got all the common shortcuts in 3 pages, all the common shortcuts that most artists use. And it's printer friendly, so you can print it out, stick it on your wall, enjoy. So that was part one. Hope you learned something. Click here to join me in part two right now. Let's get into it. In this video, you'll learn how to move, rotate, and scale any object, as well as how to use the modifier stack. And if you stick right to the end of the video, you'll learn how to turn your donut into a little breakdance of doing the worm. Just something fun to do. Alright, so in the last video, we didn't actually make anything. We just moved around and stuff like that. We set a monkey head on fire, but again, that was something stupid. Now we're actually going to start to assemble the scene, which is a donut sitting on a table. So I mentioned this briefly at the end of the last video, the final thing. But to delete in Blender, you can do that by hitting the X key, or you can actually just push the delete key, but X will delete. So I'm going to start by placing the table. So, and I mentioned this in the last video as well, Shift A is how you add any object into Blender, so you can see all of the options here. And as I mentioned, it's usually always a mesh. That's usually what you always need. And these objects here, you pick the one which most resembles what it is that you're trying to create. So if you were making like a cup, you would generally pick a cylinder. If you were making a house, you might pick a cube. But in our case, we're just going to start with the table. So let's go and add in the plane to the object. You can just drag it. Anyway, so we're scaling it. Yay, good for us. Now, if you hold down Control during any movement, it'll move it in increments. And if you hold down Shift, it will move it in like really subtle, slight movements. So, yeah. But anyway, we're going to hold down Control just so that it gets to that little grid floor there. Just, it's not really that important, but I just like to keep it nice and tidy, so I keep it on the grid floor. Alright, so we've got a plane here. Now, let's go ahead and add in our donut. So I'm going to hit Shift A again, and which of these objects most resemble a donut? Why, it's the Taurus! Taurus. I think Taurus is one of the objects that I use the least. It's like one of those things where it's like, when do you ever need an object that looks like this? It just so happens to be a donut. So yeah, it's a good beginner to do it. So the options for the object that you got when you first added it in here, they can only be edited the moment after you add them. So let's just do that again. So I deleted it with X, Shift A, and add another Taurus. Yeah, so you can see the options here. Like if I wanted to change the segments, like how high resolution I want my donut to be. By the way, don't, like I remember when I started Blender, I'm like, everything's gonna be high res. And I made everything just ridiculous high poly mesh, which is not what you want to do. So you want to use as few vertices as possible. But anyway, so let's say we want to adjust the segments here or whatever. You would do this the moment after you add the object. And I think this is the thing will appear in every 3D software you use because there are three axes. So this top axis here, this blue one, it's called the Z axis, and it represents vertical movement up and down. This green one represents the Y axis, which represents side to side, and then of course the red one is the X, which represents the depth, like backwards and forwards. Now the reason I'm telling you this is that so you can move an object by hitting the little arrow key, but you can also move it by hitting the G key. And just like before, it's now moving to your mouse. So you can click on it, and then when you want to stop it, you just click and it's there. But as well as that, so while you're moving it on G, you can also, after you've pressed G, if you type the letter of any of those axes, like say X, it will now snap it and only move to its X axis. Or I can tap Y, Y or Z, and then move to the Z axis. But if you don't even want to have to remember those axes, there's even a quicker way of doing it. And that is to, whilst you're moving it, if you push the middle mouse key, little mouse button there, if you hold it down, I should say, and then you point it in the direction of the axis that you want it to go, and you can see it now pointing towards the X-axis, this one is moving into the right. Why is it moving there? So you don't even have to remember the names of them. You can just push the middle mouse key and start moving it to that axis. So what this means is, like, this is how most artists work. You just go like, right, I'm gonna move it over there, now I'm moving it down over there. Like, it's very quick. So because when you if you don't use